My name is Dr. Sirinthorn Chansirikan. I'm a geriatrician at Ramathibodi Hospital Medical School under Mahidol University. I think there are a little bit difference between quality aging as well as active aging.
Mm-hmm.
But it's very difficult to define it in detail. However, we think that active aging a bit more social. You know what I mean? It means social, but quality is someone's feel is about physical health or health more than health. But active aging, it seems that you combine about social life as well, something like that. In the WHO that we work with older persons, we said that the things that we think is better is that you may have health and security and as well as participation. You know, these three pillars makes this is make it to active aging. Something like that. You understand what I mean?
Yeah.
So if you talk about quality aging, it means like health only,
mm-hmm.
or health or a little bit money,
mm-hmm.
or something. But if you talk about active, it means participation, play a little bit bigger part, something like that. In Thailand, in the past 20 to 30 years ago, I, as a medical student, listened about people suffering from the disease with the what we call the vicious cycle.
Mm-hmm.
In Thai, we call it "jon ngo jeb." It means that if you don't have enough education, we call it "ngo." Ngo it means not very good in not good in intelligence. And then with you don't have any knowledge, something like that, then you have some disease, you jeb. And then with you some disease, you have to pay more for remedy or for doctor or nursing care, something like that. It's made you poverty.
Mm-hmm.
So and the vicious cycle going on and on, something like this.
Mm-hmm.
So when we want to make things better, we need to break down that cycle. It means that you make and we try to intervene it, intervene this cycle in at every point that we can. For example, if we think that if you have no money, you try to make you more money, that you can access to better better food, better water, sanitation or something like that. And if you have no knowledge, you put some knowledge or what we call health literacy, mm-hmm. to them, and then they can use these things to make their life better.
Mm-hmm.
And we can, and then we put something about how you can spend money, how you can use your money to have a better health and pay less for remedy or something like that. Instead of buying medication, you better buying better food that prevent the disease better than buy the medication to remedy the disease.
Mm-hmm.
I think that this project is a successful and is going to be one of the projects that can help the country,
mm-hmm.
to get better things about healthcare. The beginning of the year, that Thai people have a newborn baby more than 1 million birth per year from 1953 to 1973. For 20 years. In Thai Ministry of Public Health said that older person in Thai is 60 years old,
mm-hmm.
plus. From 1953, these people will go to 60 years old in 2023.
Mm-hmm.
That's another 6 years to go. And the first 1 million baby going to be the older persons.
Mm-hmm.
And this million is go repeatedly every year for 20 years. You know, that a huge mass of our older persons over there. And I think that if they something like this happen, and most of them not healthy, is a big burden to the country. So we know that most of them are now in their 40 to 50. If we do something that make them understand what happened to the body when you get old, and what happened if you don't eat better, eat quality food or something like that, you will sick, you will get illness before you go to 60 years old. And that is a chronic illness, and you know as non-communicable disease, right? And with non-communicable disease, the complication is a stroke, cardiovascular problems, or others that make them disability. You know, they can live by themselves and need other people to care for them or let them die. So I think that this is the very important period that we need to make the people who are still in their active life, what you mean, working years, to do better things to their body and prepare everything for their life in the next 40, 50 years. You know, because people live longer, you retire 60 and then you need 40 years to go ahead, and you don't have money, and your body is getting worse and worse, the disease is go more and more and more, and then you disable. It's not good. And it's another thing is that with the habit of eating, lifestyle, something changed, you get NCD, for example, hypertension or diabetes in younger people. When I was a medical student 30 years ago, most of the hypertensive patients, people who have but high blood pressure, come to see doctor about 50 years old. But now we find them around their 30. That is the problem. We need to make people prepare for their aging.